Hello and welcome to What's New in FS Spec. Before I start describing that, I will show you one of the integrations that FS Spec has. In this case with X-Array, which you might know, is a package for handling multidimensional arrays with labels along the axes. So I set this going and you can see that I am passing a particular HTTP URL here, and X-Array will eventually be able to open the XAR dataset that is contained there and will show you the contents of that dataset. This was shown to me as an example of a case in which things were going particularly slowly and it took some working out to figure out why that was. It turns out that this particular dataset in fact consists of very many chunks in one of the coordinate dimensions, and X-Array is loading the coordinates eagerly so that you can then do labeled indexing on the data when it becomes available. Each of the chunks in this particular coordinate dimension only contains a handful of elements, and there are 1,300 of these chunks in total, and FSSpec is looping over these one by one, sending a request to the server, getting a very small piece of data back, interpreting it, and then moving on to the next chunk. So it's going serially, and this is going very slowly for 1,300 requests. In a moment, I will show you how this now works with the new version of FSSpec. In the meantime, while this is still running, I'll remind you of some of FSSpec's core features, which are that it provides a uniform API over many backend implementations of file system-like things. These include client-server interactions like FTP and SSH. It includes cloud storage such as Amazon S3 and Google and Azure, and some more exotic things like GitHub and Dask Workers and various other things that you might find interesting. In each of these cases, though, you can treat the remote file as a file system as you would the local one, and it will produce real Python file-like objects, which you can then pass to various packages that expect those kind of things. And it turns out there are quite a few of these. So I won't go over the various features of FSSpec. You can read the documentation when you have time. But there are several of these, so I'll leave them on the screen for a little while. I find that the very last one down here is the most interesting, which is that FSSpec has become a de facto layer for various different packages to be able to access their data wherever it may be on those various different backends. So there are direct integrations with Dask and Pandas, and you can see X-Array is working here. So after nearly 3 minutes, this is complete and the coordinates of the data have loaded. I'd just like to point out the actual data itself have not loaded here. This is also leveraging Dask under the hood to load those lazily, but just getting the basic metadata and the coordinates of the data already took 3 minutes, and this is very long. So what can we do about this? Well, as I already mentioned, each of the requests was being waited on in a serial manner. So the obvious thing that you want to do is launch all of these requests concurrently. And so you only need to wait for typically one or two times the initial wait period for all of those to come back from the server. So in the new version of FSSpec, this is now currently available, it works like this. So now we have the, well, this is actually an even slightly simpler one command version of the same thing that happened on the left. This has become slightly simpler to do. You can see it executes and it brings the same data set down, and it has taken just a few seconds to do it. So this is a speed up of an order of, I don't know, 20, 30 times faster, something like that. So a very nice benefit there. There is more, however. So here is a slightly different version of the same command. And now I have this extra part to the URL here. And this is going to cache the files to my local storage as they arrive. And I specify where that local storage is here. And we can put all of this in a single command that works through X-Array. So all these things are nicely plumbed together. You don't have to go from library to library. You can just pass arguments. Now, the first time I run this, this is still going to take the 5 seconds that it took before, or slightly faster in this case. The second time I run it, though, it's now reading from local storage and it happens very quickly. And again, I've done this just by including this extra part of the URL here, and everything else is handled by FSSpec. And naturally, as you would expect, because the whole purpose of FSSpec is to be able to handle lots of different kinds of backends, this will also work transparently with, in this case, Google Cloud Storage is the GCS protocol. And again, with the X-ray example, this is the same data set now on a very different kind of storage. Everything else looks the same. I do need to specify here something for my Google authentication because this is on my own private bucket in this particular case. But when I run this, you shouldn't be surprised that this also just takes a few seconds. And when it does, we will have the fact it's slightly slower this time. This is doubtless just my local internet fluctuating. But once it's done, we have, again, the same data set as before is ready for us here. So async offers bulk operations like this. So if you are trying to retrieve many files, you can do those concurrently. If you're trying to copy or delete many files, you can do those operations concurrently. But if you're writing an async program yourself, if you're already used to async await syntax, then you can hook directly into the API that is available for the backends that support it. Currently, those backends are HTTP, Google Storage, Amazon S3, and Azure Blob. That is second generation for those that know their Azure. So you can hook into those from an async application, and you will not have to wait for blocking functions as you previously did. That is it. So I can end here slightly early. A lot of things have changed in FSSpec over the summer that I don't have time to go into. I encourage you to try it and report bugs as usual. Let us know your opinions. Thanks very much.